In this video, we're going to look at a special note within the Notes app. It's called a Quick Note. With a Quick Note, what we're able to do is quickly jot down a note without even leaving an app. Now, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at these Quick Notes on the iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. Now, as I mentioned in the introduction, with Quick Notes, what we're able to do is create a note or jot down notes without ever opening up the Notes app. So how do we do that? Well, basically, there's two different ways we can do this. We can do this through the share icon, or we can do this through the control center. Let's first take a look at it through the share icon. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go into Safari here. And what I would like to do is create a Quick Note on this. Well, all I do is just go over here to the share icon, and when I tap on that, instead of tapping on notes, that's going to open up the Notes app. I don't want to do that. What I want to do is I want to create a Quick Note. I swipe up, and you're going to see the option to add to a Quick Note. When I tap on this, what it does is it opens up a new card. We can actually see Safari in the background there. So basically, I've never left Safari. I'm still in Safari, but what I'm able to do is go and create a note. So this is the website. I can go and type it in there. It automatically added that website link in there. And now I just tap on save. It takes me back to Safari and it saved that note. So where did it save it to? Well, it saved it to my notes, but it's in a special folder called Quick Notes. So let's go over to my notes here. And when we look at my folders now, you're going to see I have Quick Notes. And when I tap on that, there is my Tulip Time website. I tap on that, and I can go and view that note. As of this point here, it is just a standard note. I have all of the same options that it did before. It's just stored in the Quick Note folder. And if I wanted to move it out of there, I could. I could long press on it, and then I can go and move this. So that's how we can create Quick Notes with the share icon. Another nice feature with that is, let's go back over to Safari, and this works from within any app as long as you have that share icon. But if I were to select text in here, when I create a Quick Note, what it's going to do is it's going to copy that text. So I tap on the share icon here, and I go up to Add to Quick Note. I tap on it. It's going to add that to that note, and we have that text. So it saved the link to that website, but it also saved the text to that. So now when I tap on save, and we go back over to my notes, you're going to see I have two of them here. And when I tap on this, I can see the website as well as that text that I selected. So I tap on this, and it takes me over to that website. And we can basically do this from within any app that we have that share icon. So if I go to Maps, and let's go to Hops, one of my favorite restaurants here. I want to add that as a Quick Note. All I have to do is tap on Share, and you're going to see the option to Add to New Quick Note. And when I tap on that, it's going to add it to a new Quick Note. You can see it adds that link in there. And now when I go over to my notes, we now have three of them, and one of them is to my Maps app. We have another way of creating a Quick Note, and that is through the Control Center. But we have to kind of set this one up. So how do we do that? Well, let's go over to my Control Center. I'm just going to flick down from the upper right-hand corner to get to my Control Center. With iOS 18, what we're able to do is modify these controls. How do we do that? We long press. So I'm going to long press in this area here where there's no control. And now what I'm able to do is add a new control. The control I want to add is Quick Note. So I tap on it, and I'm going to search for Quick Note, and you're going to see we have Quick Note here. I tap on that, and now we can see we have my Quick Note icon. So what does this do? Well, this allows me to create a Quick Note from within any app as well, but it doesn't necessarily share. So I tap on this, and now I can create a new Quick Note. Type in what I want, and then when I'm done, I would tap on save, and it'll save that note. But it doesn't leave the app. So if I'm in the Photos app here, I want to create a Quick Note. I just flick down, go over to my icon here. I can write what I want in here. hit save, and I've created that quick note. So that is how we create quick notes on the iPhone. It's an easy way to create a note without ever leaving an app. We have two different ways we can do this. We can do this by the share icon, or what we can do is add a control to the control center, and then from there, you're able to create a new quick note. And again, when you use this method, the quick note method, it never leaves the app. When you do create a quick note, it puts it into a special folder within the Notes app. We are able to move it out of that folder if you want. Just long press on it, you can move it out of that folder. So that is how we create quick notes with the Notes app on the iPhone. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can subscribe to my channel. You can share it with your friends and family. In addition to that, what you may want to do is check out danstutorials.com. Not only do I have more videos there, but I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and I host classes and webinars on a regular basis. So how can you help support my efforts in creating these videos? It is a membership-based site. When you become a member of my site, what I'll do for you is I'll remove all of the ads from the videos. You have access to that AI assistant, and you have access to my classes and webinars. Also, you are helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some large organization. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.